上周 Ketanji Brown Jackson 通过了任命，成为了最高法院的大法官。在左派的眼里，这是一个非常值得纪念的高光时刻。白宫发言人 Jen Psaki 说，这真的让大家都觉得好激动，好激动哦，每个人都哭得很丑。
In the poetic words of Dr. Maya Angelou, I do so now while bringing the gifts my ancestors gave. I am the dream and the hope of a slave.
Can you give us any, peel back the curtain? What was it like with her and President Biden behind the scenes?
It was, as you know, Dana, from working on these in the past, it was a very emotional day in the White House, a joyful day. And there's so many days in the White House, no matter who you work for, that are exhausting and heartbreaking and challenging because there aren't easy answers to hard problems sometimes. But this was an incredibly joyful day, a day we celebrated, a day many of us were ugly crying on the White House South Lawn, just celebrating this remarkable woman, who is making history, but she is also so qualified, to serve on the Supreme Court. So it was really a day I will remember for a long time to come.
这的确是一个应该被我们每个人都记住的时刻，因为这样一个极左的对儿童性犯罪案件手下留情的法官，不光得到了全部民主党人的支持，这里面还有三名共和党人也都投了支持票。缅因州的共和党参议员 Susan Collins，阿拉斯加州的共和党参议员 Lisa Murkowski 和犹他州的共和党参议员 Mitt Romney。 当然不管这三名共和党人投不投票，这个大法官他一定都是稳进的，但是这位大法官的认证也引发了对美国儿童未来的担忧，因为他在过去当法官的记录中对于儿童色情片和儿童性侵案的量刑是非常非常的弱，只要经他手的案件，儿童色情这一块，他的量刑都会比正常的刑期减少30%到50%。现在的孩子正在面临着四面楚歌的危机，不管我们迎来一个在最高法院都不愿意保护儿童的人，孩子去的学校也已经不再是单纯的教导学习知识的地方，而是变成了一个左派的洗脑工厂。新泽西州的教育部出台了一项官方规定，这个规定说学校应该怎么对待同性和变性的问题呢？那作为学区来讲，应该要完全的接受学生认定的性别身份，并且不需要家长的同意。学区工作人员应该与学生进行公开但是保密的讨论，以确定学生在选择名字、选择使用代词和家长沟通等问题上的偏好。想想看，这有多可怕！学生有了心理方面的问题，不能让家长知道，学校和学生一起对家长隐瞒，有什么问题，来学校啊，学校尊重你，你可以在学校里面改名字，告诉老师，你的性别是什么？你叫 Jack， 但是你想当女孩吗？没关系，那你以后在学校的身份，你就是一个女生，你叫 Mary。 你家里还不知道你想要变性的事吗？没关系，如果你不想告诉家长，学校也帮着你，我们保证不会告诉你的爸爸妈妈。现在教育部出台了这样一个规定，那么所有的学校都要开始遵守，都要开始实行。一旦有了这样的命令，那么作为老师呢，就面临着两种选择，要不然你就老老实实的按照学校说的去做，如果你实在感觉到良心上过不去，那你就别干了，辞职吧。但是呢，这里面有一部分老师是非常非常开心的，因为他们自己本身就是变性人。如果要不是现在媒体陆续的曝光，我都不知道有这么多变性人的老师在学校里面教小孩。在波士顿地区有一个特许学校，学校就专门在 Zoom 上面开了一节网课，这节课是开放给幼儿园一年级和两年级的学生的。他们请来的讲员讲的主题是要跟小朋友一起分享他的身份，他是谁，以及他最喜欢自己的哪个部分。
And something cool about me, Miss Hammond? All right. All right, so something that's really cool and unique about who I am is that I am transgender. So we touched a little bit about that at the beginning of this week in the book that Ms. Hammond read, but I'm going to give you my explanation about what it means to be transgender as well. So when babies are born, the doctor looks at them and they make a guess about whether the baby is a boy or a girl based on what they look like. And most of the time, that guess is 100% correct. There are no issues whatsoever. But sometimes the doctor is wrong. The doctor makes an incorrect guess. When the doctor makes a correct guess, that's when a person is called cisgender. When a doctor's guess is wrong, that's when they are transgender. So I'm a man, but when I was a baby, the doctors told my parents I was a girl. And so my parents gave me a name that girls typically have and bought me clothes that girls typically wear. And until I was 18 years old, everyone thought I was a girl. And this was super, super uncomfortable for me because I knew that wasn't right. The way I like to describe it is like wearing a super itchy sweater. The longer you wear it, the itchier it gets. And the only way to make the itching stop is to have everyone see and know the person that you really are. So when I was 18, I told my family and my friends that I'm really a boy. And it was like this huge weight had been lifted off of my shoulders and I had the freedom to be who I truly am. And even though this experience is super challenging sometimes, it made me the person I am, and I'm super proud to be transgender.
作为变性人很酷吗？觉得自己和别人与众不同吗？从青春期的时候开始，很多人就希望被人关注，所以就会看到有很多的小孩子，尤其是现在左派的小孩，满脸打满了钉，满胳膊纹着纹身，头发染得像鹦鹉，要不然就是穿得很暴露，这些都是为了吸引人的注意和目光而选择的一种展现自己的方式。现在最新的方式是改变自己的性别，我的性别与众不同，因为我天生就跟你们不一样。医生能够从出生的婴儿就定义谁是男的谁是女的吗？他或许看到了我的外表，但是他看不到我的内心。有多少的孩子会因为老师这样的教导，然后自己正好也想要得到别人的关注，于是某一天灵机一动就说我是变性人。或许他们只是想要得到表扬，或许他们只是想要让别人羡慕他们关注他们。变性就是老师教的最快捷的成功方式。你不需要在任何的方面有任何的才艺，你也不需要在某方面特别优秀，你就可以获得众人的目光，你就可以变成一个少数群体里的一员，在做着大部分人都没有在做的而且不敢做的先进的 gender identity。 我并不是在说吸引别人的注意力是坏事，这并不是坏事，其实每个人都非常想要得到别人的关注，但是在这么小的年龄，幼儿园、小学，独立思考能力还没有建设完全的时候，你要教他什么？你要告诉他男女不分，性别可以随意更改，通过这种方式来洗脑他们，让他们真的认为自己是变性人，在学校的保护下面，他们去接受那些变性的激素针，接受那些切除器官的手术，这是在彻底的损害一个人的心理健康和身体健康。 Brian Ruka 的儿子在波士顿的公立学校系统上小学五年级，有一天这位爸爸就发现，哎，学校给孩子留的作业是阅读一个短篇小说，阅读了之后要回答问题，那这个小说的名字叫什么呢？这个小说的名字叫性别揭示，这里面讲的是一个13岁的 non-binary 儿童的故事。 non-binary 是什么？我做新闻做了这么久了，我总是忘记。那今天我们一起再来复习一下这个左派的概念。 non-binary 就是非二元性别，认为自己不属于两个性别其中的任何一个，不是男的也不是女的，所以学校让孩子们去读的这个小说的主角就是一个认为自己不是男孩也不是女孩的13岁的孩子。父亲看到了这样的作业内容就感到非常的担心，于是他就联系学校说他对这个作业内容感到很担心，他申请孩子不做这个作业。但是学校给出的回复却让他感到大跌眼镜。学校的系统公平办公室的主任告诉他，学校了解他的担忧， 但是这一门课程，这一个作业，它不属于性教育，并且非常符合当地地区的政策和目标。随后，学校就拒绝了家长的请求，还是要求这个孩子要继续上课。学校在这里说我们不能给你开一个豁免，说不让你的孩子参与到这些涉及到性别认同或者是性取向的讨论和作业中。于是这一位父亲就参加了当地的校董会，在会上对这件事情发表了他的看法。
My name is Brian Ruka, and my son is a fifth grader at the Kenny Elementary School in Dorchester.My wife and I are concerned about a recent assignment given to the fifth grade during English language class. The 10 and 11-year-old children were given a story titled The Gender Reveal. They had to read the story and comprehend it. If you're not familiar with the story, it's about a soon-to-be 13-year-old boy named Malcolm. Throughout the story, Malcolm discusses being nervous about telling his friends and family that he will be identifying as non-binary. It is also specifically mentioned that Malcolm has already come outto everybody as gay years ago. At what grade level are children being taught about sexual orientation and the controversial topic of gender identity, which is also known by the term gender dysphoria? When were these topics inserted into the curriculum? I remember being informed when Common Core math was introduced. Why weren't parents notified about an assignment that focused 100% on a child's plan to arbitrarily decide to change his sex? Does the school committee believethat BPS English teachers have the appropriate training to handle topics that venture into the sexual neighborhood of sexual orientation and sexual biology? I spoke with the director of training and accommodations from the Office of Equity earlier this week. She informed me that she determined that this material was not considered to be sexual health education and that it is considered age appropriate. To that, I say shame on her and shame on this committee for determining what is age appropriate for my child.My child is a statistic to you. Your job is to teach our children how to read and write, how to add and subtract. It's not to indoctrinate children into a radical progressive worldview. We can all agree that 2 + 2 = 4. We clearly do not all agree on the definition of male and female. This material has no business being introduced to elementary school students. I was told that this topic is considered the same as race and religion.How would the committee react if this story was about a 13-year-old that suddenly found Jesus Christ? How about a child that was excited to attend the March for Life? I suspect you would hear more of a backlash. Do conservative religious families have to just shut up and take it because we are in the minority? Where is the equity for us? Where is our inclusion? It's a sad time in our society when adult educators use their status and influence to focus on a political agenda at the expense of our kids.Get back to teaching our children the truth, not an ideology. I pray that God will give you the strength to do what is right. Thank you for your time.
就像这位父亲说的一样，学校的教科书里面怎么就不写一写13岁的男孩是如何找到耶稣的呢？为什么要写一个13岁的男孩就认为自己不男不女了呢？这些激进的议程开始大量的伤害小孩。我们在一个国家里，在一个社会里，在一个家庭里，每个人都最应该保护的是什么呢？最最基本的就是生命和儿童。每个人的生命都是生命，并不因为贫穷或者富有而造成生命的高低贵贱，也不因为身体是否残缺，或者这个人出现在所谓的错误的时间、错误的地点，所以理应该死。儿童是每个家庭的未来，是带有我们血脉的，承接我们产业，继续生活在地上的人。当我们已经开始认为堕胎是在保护女性权利的时候，当我们把杀人的罪当作是维护某些人自由权利的时候，当我们的孩子被政治手段利用，被性化，被骗去打变性激素，切除器官的时候，人们都在鼓掌叫好，并且还在帮助急速地推进这些魔鬼的计划的时候，这就已经证明我们到了一个自我毁灭的边缘。我们的社会越来越发展，越来越像圣经旧约中记载的索多玛、俄摩拉城，充斥着乱性、儿童性化等等神极其厌恶的罪。当我们完全丧失了基本常识的时候，我们没有办法分辨对错好坏的价值观的时候，人就会肆意妄为，这就更加的证明我们需要神的拯救。好，非常感谢你的收看，那以上就是我们今天全部的内容，我是弗丽莎，我们下次再见。